Well, mate, this is a real predicament we find ourselves in. So I've woken up here in this place apparently called Good Springs, so the doctor tells me. I've apparently been shot in the head and left for dead somewhere near here, apparently, and some robot pulled me out of a grave. And all I seem to have on me are the, my usual outfit here. The old weathered 10mm pistol that I've had forever. And that's it. A couple hundred caps and a cigarette. Which I've decided to smoke, of course. All my drugs are gone. All my booze is gone. Most of my caps are gone. I'm poor. I don't have any weapons other than this pistol. I got nothing to meet. And worst yet, I don't remember what the hell's been going on for the last 3+ years. I mean, I remember everything from Cyrodiil, remember everything from the Capital Wasteland, remember getting on that train and coming here. And the last thing I remember is the train starting to move. After that, I don't remember a damned thing. I don't know where Sid's gotten off to. I don't know what I've been doing here, other than apparently I was working as a courier for something called the Mojave Express. Other than that, I ain't got a clue, mate. I'm just glad you're still with me. But we're gonna have to get out there and find out what we've been up to, where all of our stuff is, and who tried to kill us. And of course we're gonna take some revenge on that fucker once we find him. But, I guess it's time to head out that door and see where life has dropped us. You ready, Meat? Meat, where'd you go? God damn it, Meat, come on. Meat, what on earth are you doing? Here, go find some ammo or something. There you go, buddy. What do you got for me? Good boy, Meat. Let's get going. Come on. Alright. Well, let's see what's out there. Of course, Meat. As soon as we step outside, it starts to rain. I don't really like the looks of this weather. Not one bit. Maybe we should get inside, Meat. Oh dear. This seems to be a radiation storm. Take cover in here. I'll just wait it out in here. Alright, mate. Sounds like the storm's over. It's an interesting little shack, though. It appears to be owned by this Victor, who's the robot that pulled us out of the grave. So I'm guessing he doesn't really need any of these amenities. Guessing we could pretty much use this place as a crash pad if we needed to. Got a bed and everything. But being 8 o'clock in the morning, we don't really need to sleep at the moment, so... Let's head out there now that the weather's nice and try to get our bearings. Alright, well. But that sky, huh? We are definitely in the desert. It's definitely a lot more red and brown here than it was back home. Well, let's start by finding this Victor fella. As much as I hate robots, he probably makes the most sense to start our investigation with. As he pulled me out of the grave and all. Oh, who's this guy? Looks like Enclave. Well, he's not attacking, so we'll leave him alone for now. Alright, robot, where are you? That looks like a robot, though, not one I've ever seen before. Looks a little fancier than the ones from back home.
Howdy, partner! Might I say you're looking fit as a fiddle?
You are a weird robot.
I'm a Securitron. Robco Security Model 2060B. If you ever see any of my brothers, tell them Victor says howdy.
I will do so before I fry their insides.
I was out for a stroll that night when I heard the commotion up the old bone orchard. Saw what looked like a bunch of bad eggs, so I laid low.
Wuss.
Once they'd run off, I dug you up to see if you were still kicking. Turns out you were. So I hauled you off to the dock right quick.
Damn, I owe my life to a robot. I don't know how to feel about this.
Don't mention it. I'm always ready to lend a helping hand to a stranger in need. Happy trails!
Alright, well. I guess, now we should... talk to this Sunny Smiles person. Porn star name if I ever heard one. Wouldn't mind getting a few of her holotapes. If you know what I'm saying, meat. That is some real conversation for your ass, meat. So, we will, we'll find her. She's apparently gonna help me, learn about the local environment. Put it into the new edition of the guide.
Stay. Don't worry, she won't bite unless I tell her to.
You don't look like a porn star, but, you know, whatever.
Not in Good Springs, no. But if you're up for a little scavenging, there's always the schoolhouse.
I'm always up for scavenging.
There's junk, but there's this old safe that even Easy Pete wasn't able to crack with dynamite. If you want to take a shot,
Easy Pete, eh?
Take these. If the lock's too much for you to handle, reading through the magazine might give you the edge you need. You'll need those to pick the lock. Be careful, though. Put too much pressure on them, and they'll snap. Always happy to help someone down on their luck.
Right on.
Sure. What do you want to know?
Anything, really. I don't know anything about the area.
Southeast of here is Prim. Can't miss it. Since it has the giant old roller coaster right in the middle of town. The NCR's got an outpost there. If you follow the road north, you'll eventually hit Sloan and Quarry Junction. They mine rocks or something, but I heard they got troubles lately. I wouldn't head that direction if I were you, though. Got critters up there that don't take kindly to getting shot. The New California Republic. Bunch of settlers and soldiers coming from the west, fixing on making Nevada their own.
Government.
They can be right pushy, but the roads are safer because of them, so I tend to let it go. Not that I got a choice. Well, the wildlife for one thing, rowdy locals for another. They're protecting their own. Just happens to help us. They've been holding off this other group from the east, too. Got a funny name. Call themselves Caesar's Legion. Never seen them in these parts, so I couldn't tell you much. I hear rumors, that's about it. Supposedly, they keep slaves and they got some real nasty ways of killing folks. But maybe that's just something folks in the NCR cooked up to make themselves seem more useful here. Less invited.
Sounds like something bureaucrats would do.
Around here, mostly coyotes and geckos. The coyotes are pretty dangerous in large packs, but otherwise they're nothing to really worry about. The geckos aren't too tough, but they've got a nasty
geckos?
Bite.
I've heard about geckos, little tiny lizards.
But I've never seen them. Stick to the roads when you can, and steer clear of the hills north of Good Springs. The critters up there are big and poisonous. If you want to know anything else, just ask. I hunt geckos mostly. The meat's pretty good, and I can always find a buyer for the hides. I also help keep the town clear of rat scorpions and coyotes. Not many people live in Good Springs, so wildlife is always creeping in. Yeah, I guess there's a thing or two I could show you.
I don't think you really need to show me much, but, whatever.
Meet me outside, behind the saloon.
This way. Guess so. Oh, wow, look, our dogs could be twins. Why don't you try to get some dog meat?
Now, see the sarsaparilla bottles.
You gave me a rifle, apparently.
Take this and try to hit a couple of them.
I think I can do that.
That's the right idea. Look down the sight. Try crouching down and staying still. It'll help your aim. Nice shot. Well, that's a start. But I don't reckon you came to me to learn to fight sarsaparilla bottles.
Well, what, I don't know. I like fighting bottles.
I got to take geckos away from our water supply anyway. Darn critters are attracted to it. Why don't you come along? Follow me.
I guess so.
It's just down to the southeast a short ways.
I'm not going to use this stupid rifle, though. I'll break out my old pistol. Well, you do have a nice butt. I'm sure you could do some porn. I'm sure I could dig up a holotape recorder if you're interested. That leather look is, you know, something that people are into. You've already got the name. Might as well. Watching you walk away.
Hear that up on the ridge behind me there? We got some geckos to clear out. Bunch of little monsters is what they are. Seems like Doc Mitchell treats more gecko bites than anything else. Let's see if we can get a little closer. If we move quietly,
sneak up on them real quiet.
We're likely to hit something vital that way.
Yeah, those are definitely not what I was expecting. Well, I'll give him hell, all right. Don't you worry about that, little miss. Gotcha. Now it's your turn. the boat. Oh yeah, baby. Gecko meat. No thanks. Gecko hide's valuable though. I'll take that.
Getting the hang of it. There's two more wells that still need clearing.
Getting the hang of it.
It'd be worth a few caps to me.
Look, lady. No, wait. Did you say caps? I like caps.
Shouldn't take more than a couple minutes, especially with two of us. Come with me.
Man, but you're also dead. Plop. Next. Oh, howdy, fellers. Gotcha.
Help! I'm glad that's over. Holy moly.
Ew.
If you hadn't come here like you'd done, I'd be a goner for sure. I came up here to draw water, but here, you should have what I got.
I'd say thirsty. You should pay me with sex, but I don't think I want you to. Reputation, eh? That's a new thing. See, did you guys have any hides for me? Yeah, give me that hide. Where's the other one? I don't know. Weird. Disappearing corpse.
Now that was some good work. Even got a little exciting there at the end.
Yeah, I guess you could say that.
A little spending money for the trouble. One more thing I wanted to show you.
Cabs.
Thought
Jeez.
I might teach you about living off the land and making useful things for yourself. Interested?
Sure, I guess.
Alright then. We'll need a couple ingredients to get started. Gonna want some Xander root and a Brock flower. Let me think now. I know I've seen Brock flowers growing up at the graveyard, and I seem to remember there being Xander root over by the schoolhouse. Bring those on back to me, and we'll get cooking.
Cooking drugs, I hope.
Hey there.
Nice sack. Search the geckos we killed up here. I was too excited, my bloodlust couldn't be contained. Is that meat? No, that's Cheyenne. Cheyenne's stupid. Meat's much better. Yeah, give me that hide. And you. Yeah, skin 'em. Skin that smoke wagon, see what happens. Alright, let's see here. Alright, so apparently one of them's up by the graveyard. Which I suppose I could look for clues about my own, demise up here as well. It's not a rad scorpion, but it's kind of the same. It still gets its gross bug parts everywhere when it dies. Yeah, no meat. You're happy. Let's go. Blowflies. Gross in any part of the wasteland. Ugh. Couldn't pay me to eat that. Alright, I guess this was my grave. What we got here? Distinctive cigarette butts. Well, I should probably take one of those. What's that? Could it be meat? This meat. It's a real honest to goodness saber. Oh man, this reminds me of my days as a pirate. This is great. Look at this. Yeah. Alright. Well, I'm feeling pretty good about life all of a sudden. Alright. Oh wait. We forgot to get what we came here for. Some fucking plant or something. I guess this thing. Yep. Alright. Now, I believe that's the schoolhouse. So that's our next stop meet. But it would be stealing if I took some, apparently. And it's the doc's house. Anything in his mailbox? Nothing good. Why is a toy car in his mailbox? It's kind of weird. Alright. Sure. Bugs, and not the kind I'm used to. Ugh, yuck, get away. Stuff we need, apparently. Well, while we're here, she did say this was a good place to scav. More gross bugs. And they're getting their bug parts all over the place. Gross. Yuck. No, I don't want any mantis forelegs. Ugh. Gross. Man, bugs are just not, they're not right, man. They're not right. Well, mate, this reminds me of the old days when you first got out of the vault when, like, every little thing we find could be useful. It's not like, you know, not like it was recently when we had, you know, hundreds of bobby pins and stim packs and stuff. Kind of need to look for everything again. Do I want to open that? Oh, it makes a gross noise. Ooh, but these are worth money. But I have to touch them. Gross. Ugh, yuck. Alright. Nine bottle caps. Well, there were some stim packs and drugs and stuff, so that's good. Go see the porn star now that we have the plants.
Let me see what you got. Yeah, these'll do just fine. Just fine. All right, now. We're gonna be making something folks on the trail call healing powder. Go on over to that campfire now.
Can I snort it?
Give it a try.
This is a campfire?
Hey, that's not bad, see? All it takes to make a recipe is the right ingredients and the right know-how.
Sometimes you
say so. It won't be a campfire you need. Might need to do some work on your guns and ammo, maybe. Important thing to get is it's all the same idea. You just need to find the right place to set up shop. Workbench or reloading bench, whatever. Well, I hope that's enough to get you started. I'm heading back now. Hope I didn't miss anything good on the jukebox. Cheyenne would never forgive me. Hey, do me a favor. Trudy? She's the bartender up at the Prospector. Kind of the town mom. She likes to meet newcomers. She'd be cross with me if I didn't ask you to poke your head in and say hi.
Well, I don't really plan on staying too long, but I don't know. Maybe I'll see if there's some caps to be made before I leave. Who's this jerk? Hey, jerk, who are you?
Hello? Can you help me?
Maybe. Are there caps involved?
My girl is trapped by geckos on the ridge, and I can't get to her. Please, she's going to die.
Well, maybe I can sleep with her.
Go up the path, past the broken radio tower, and go to the right. They're at the top of the trail. You will? Thank you for helping me. Please hurry.
Yeah, I mean, your girlfriend's gonna look at me as her big strong saver and look at you as a wuss. So, yeah, you're out of luck, buddy. We'll head right on up here. For all I know, it's been a full 3 years since I've been laid. Though I kinda doubt that. Oh, hello, little gecko. God damn, you're right to hell. Taking all your hides and everything. Now, where's this lady? Ooh, there's a whole bunch of geckos. One down. Think dog meat's some kind of trick now, do you? Dog meat will fuck your shit up. As you just found out. Do not fuck with dog meat. Well, that's, pleasant. Seems to be everything, though. Doesn't look like his girl. What do we got here? Meat just triggered a trap back there. Oh, some cap. Oh, who's this guy? Johnny. Hi, Johnny. One thing we definitely haven't had since we woke up is a drink. Let's fix that right now. Actually, let's go sit in this chair and fix it. There we go. Yeah, this is the life, dog meat. It's nice and warm here. Having myself a bottle of wine sitting next to a dead body. Smoke. Yep, this is the good life, buddy. Now we just gotta find out who shot us and where the hell all of our stuff is, and we'll be doing great. Oh dear. I appear to have glitched out a bit. There we go. That's better. Okay. Well, I'm just gonna have to go tell this guy I didn't find his girl, unfortunately. Oh, here he is.
Sorry I tricked you, but thanks for clearing out the geckos. Now I can get to that stash up there, after I deal with you.
Is that what you think?
Hey!
You thought wrong, buddy. Bring a gun to a sword fight or something. Alright, let's head back to town. Let's go see this Trudy. Maybe she puts up. What time is it anyways? It's getting late already.
Hey there.
I'm done being nice. If you don't hand Ringo over soon, I'm going to get my friends and we're burning this town to the ground. Got it?
We'll keep that in mind. Now, if you're not going to buy something, get out.
I appreciate that kind of attitude.
Well, you've been causing quite a stir. Glad I finally got to meet you. Welcome to the Prospector Saloon.
Handsome SOBs like me tend to cause a stir.
Not much, other than there are a bunch of freeloaders who expected a few rounds on the house. I was able to
murderers
get
murderers and freeloaders.
Of course, one of the great cons did knock my radio to the floor by accident, and it hasn't been working since.
Fuck your radio.
They were having some kind of argument about it, but the guy in the checkered coat kept shushing them. Sounded like they came in
checkered
from the north
coat,
of Quarry Junction.
Sounds like
if
a
that's
clue.
The case, I can't say I blame them for not wanting to go back. That whole area is overrun with the kind of critters that just get mad if you shoot them. Merchants avoid that whole stretch of I-15 like it's radioactive, which it could be for all I know. I didn't hear exactly, but the leader was talking about the strip. Fellow wants to get there and avoid the 15, he'd have to go east. Take Highway 93 up.
All right.
I know that thing as much as anyone else around here. It mostly keeps to itself, which is just fine by me.
I can understand that feeling.
Other than rolling around once in a while, it doesn't do anything useful as far as I can tell. I don't know why it took an interest
most robots.
I'd be careful. It's never helped anyone before. It acts friendly enough, but I don't trust that whole cheerful cowboy act. I find it all very creepy.
Amen, sister.
It was here when I took over the saloon 7 years ago. Some people have said its owner lived here, but no one knows who it was.
Some robot-loving creep, probably.
Fine by me. Mostly traders looking to buy bighorn or meat and hides. The traders are the main reason the general store manages to stay in business. Most travelers heading south on the I-15 just push on towards Prim, unless they're in desperate need of supplies. There's always something interesting going on, but the biggest news has to be the coming dust-up between the NCR and the Legion over the dam. The new California Republic's got the most power in Nevada. Money, troops, you name it. They do what they can to keep things safe in the region. But if you ask me, they're trying to do too much. They're spread too thin.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure the NCR wants to hold on to the dam because it's one of the few places around that can make electricity. The Legion are a bunch of savages, though. No idea why they'd want the dam. Probably plan on destroying it or something. Slavers, killers, and all other kinds of trouble. They dress up like Roman soldiers.
Sounds like, everybody back east, really.
The rumor is that the Legion is far larger than the NCR lets on, and that it's been due to luck that the Legion hasn't overrun the territory. Looks like our little town got itself dragged into the middle of something we don't want anything to do with. About a week ago, this traitor, Ringo, comes into town. Survivor of an attack, he says. Bad men after him. Needs a place to hide. We figured he was just in shock, so we gave him a place to lie low. We didn't actually expect anyone to come after him. He's holed up at the abandoned gas station up the hill.
Yeah, why don't you just kill him?
You mean murder him? That's not
yeah.
the way. Even if
why not?
Scum, he can bluster and threaten all he wants.
You're stupid, huh?
Some of the others, like Sonny, will probably stand up for Ringo if he asks for help, which he hasn't. Personally, I hope he sneaks out of town one night and takes the Powder Gangers with him.
That's fair.
Chain gangs, really. The NCR brought them in from California to work on the rail lines. Problem is, it turns out that giving convicts a bunch of dynamite and blasting powder isn't the best idea.
Yeah, bureaucrats are stupid.
Long ago. Some of them stuck together so they could make trouble. That's what we're dealing with now. If you were able to get Ringo out of this mess, you'd have a decent reputation around Good Springs. I'd even set you up with a discount.
I like discounts.
Ringo would also make the Powder Gangers mad, and they've got a lot of friends out there.
Yeah, I'm not worried about a bunch of punks like them.
Don't know why you'd want to do a thing like that. Yep, you'd get on their good side, but people around here wouldn't appreciate it one bit.
Well, I was just wondering who had more caps to give me.
He's a convict, just without the chains. Said his name was Cobb. Powder Gangers is what they call themselves. Plenty more like him out there.
Convicts? What are you telling me? People have prisons out here?
Sure, the outside looks okay, but I think something broke on the inside. There'd be caps in it for
you. Just like your brain.
I do like to hear what's going on in the world. And that Mr. New Vegas seems like such a gentleman.
All right, well, let's see what I can do. Now pay up.
I can take. Yeah, I heard it turn right back on after you got done tinkering with it. Here's some caps for the work.
You can fork out a little more.
Not at all. I'm never sure how much is normally charged for this sort of thing. Here's some additional caps. That should be enough. Now, how about spending some of those caps in the saloon?
No. Alright, neat. Well, I guess we need to go find this Ringo fella. guess we're gonna side with him and the town. I don't like necessarily have a great moral reason for doing so, but I mean, they have shops and stuff, and I can get discounts, so, you know, that's better than just having a bunch of loser convicts like me. Oh, alright, I'll have a soda. I haven't actually tried this before. Hey.
Who are you? What do you want with me?
Well, Mr. Ringo, you look like somebody just walked over your grave.
Sorry about the gun. You just caught me off guard, that's all. We got off to a bad start. What say we start over with a friendly game of Caravan? You know how to play? Yeah. He doesn't look very tough, though. I hear he's afraid I'll shoot him down from one of the windows when I see him. And he's right. I'll have a much bigger problem once his friends show up. There's no way I could handle all of them in a gunfight.
So you're a wuss, is what you're telling me. All right.
I'm gonna lay low for as long as I can, assuming the town doesn't throw me to the wolves. I've got no chance against the gang on my own.
You're a punk-ass bitch, but luckily, I'm for hire. Oops, I didn't mean to skip your dialogue. Accident.
We'd just end up sharing the same grave if it's just the two of us.
Speak for yourself.
Now, if some of the other people in town were also on board... I was thinking of myself, actually. Who's gonna watch my back while I'm watching yours?
You're a wuss.
Start with Sunny Smiles. She's been friendlier than most around here.
And I sure wouldn't mind watching her back, if you know what I'm saying, buddy. Alright, what do you get to loot in here? Booze. Nice sack. Or the soda that I still haven't tried yet. Seems to be an awful lot of it out here. Not much Nuka-Cola so far. No, caps. I do like caps. Those are stealing, huh? What about the safe? Nope. More caps. And smokes. Good, I was running low. Alright. Well, back to Sunny. Hey, it's the Wasteland Survival Guide. This guy knows what's up. Well, even if he is in weird, creepy Enclave armor.
Hi there. Sticking around Good Springs for a while longer?
Yeah, I guess so. I'm trying to make a little money.
Say no more. I'm in.
I wonder if it's this easy to talk you into bed.
That's inspiring. You may want to keep your optimism to yourself if you try to recruit anyone else. Joe Cobb talks about leaving us alone if we hand over Ringo. But I know his type. He and his friends will come after the town eventually. However, between you, me, and Ringo, we aren't exactly a force to be reckoned with.
Once again, speak for yourself. Trudy.
If you could convince Trudy to join us, some of the folks in town might decide to help out as well. I know Easy Pete's got a stock of dynamite somewhere. And Chet just got a shipment of leather armor we could borrow. Talk to them as well. Finally, there's a good chance we'll all end up with extra holes in us. So if Doc Mitchell could cough up some extra stim packs, that'd be great. A silver tongue would help.
Oh.
Convincing Trudy that
I have a silver tongue, all right, honey. You might call me a cunning linguist.
Everything give is in Chet's vocabulary. Even with the town at stake,
man after my own heart.
Still make you barter with him. Easy Pete's pretty protective of his dynamite. You'd have to convince him you know a thing or two about explosives before you handed it over.
Would sticking a live grenade in his pocket get that across? Alright, well, I guess we'll start with Trudy.
So you're planning on taking on Joe Cobb's gang. It's a big risk, but I suppose you have to do what you think is right.
Is that a revolver in a glass over there?
That does sound like a good plan. All right, you seem to know what you're doing, so you can count me in. Let me have a word with a few other folks, and I'll see if I can't round up some more members for this militia you're creating. While everyone does own a gun, we could stand to be a little better equipped. The general store probably has what we need in stock.
It is indeed a revolver and a cup. Alright, back outside. Let's talk to Easy Pete. He's right here.
Howdy. What can Easy Pete do for you?
Don't be so easy, I guess.
Too dangerous. Wanna kill all yourselves if I let you touch it.
Oh, yup.
Better leave it buried. Safer that way.
No.
Uh-huh. Guess you know what you're doing. I'll go dig it up and get it ready.
And you people are all really easily convinced.
The one in the fancy suit seemed to be calling the shots. That's as much as I know. Other folks in town might know more. Word of advice, though, if you ever catch up with him, watch out. The man's got cold eyes like a snake. Can't be trusted, I'd say. Bad trouble. Welcome. Was a prospector until I decided to settle here to get away from the NCR. Now we'll just take it easy and help out with the Brahmin and Bighorners. Nah. Means I poke through old buildings looking for working tech and such. Some folks just call it salvaging, but never like the term. Way I see it, salvage means it's broken, near worthless. Me, I look for the good stuff. Guns, chems, spare parts. Good money in it.
I like your style, old man.
Nope. Had a pretty good claim once, way out east by the river, but got run off by raiders. Eventually got too old to keep going out. Don't get me wrong, the NCR's got a lot of decent folk in it. It's just that they make you part of them, whether you like it or not.
Yeah, fucking land-hungry bureaucrats.
Things and Prim don't stay independent for long. Not if you've got something the NCR wants. Still, the NCR keeps the Legion away. They're slavers, led by a guy named Caesar, or Kaisar. Not sure how you're supposed to say it. A couple of years ago, they tried to take over Hoover Dam, but the NCR beat them back. The NCR didn't or couldn't finish the job, though. The Legion's got its strength back and is getting ready for another round at the dam. My money's still on the NCR winning, but you never know. We've been hearing stories about legionaries on the Nevada side of the river, so keep a gun handy. You don't want to get caught by them.
I always keep a gun handy, and I'm handy with the steel.
The dam powers a lot of New Vegas, and then there's all that clean water lying in Lake Mead, too. Anybody who owns the dam owns the territory.
Good to know.
Meet and hide, mostly.
Seems like there's a lot of opportunity here.
Until you take it
I like opportunity.
You can find a bunch of wild ones high up in the hills, but gotta be careful around them. They can put up a decent fight if cornered. The machine, harmless, no matter what Trudy says.
Robots.
He thinks it's hiding something.
Probably
I
is.
I think it's just a broken down relic with no place to be.
It's probably that too.
Keep your gun handy if you go poking around some of the abandoned places around here, like the schoolhouse. Critters move in there sometimes.
You people around here really like that term critters, don't you? Go, Tumbleweed, go! Boom. Yeah, let's play Tumbleweed Soccer. mind. It's not as much fun as it seemed like. Alright, I gotta convince Doc Mitchell. And while I'm here, I don't think I really did a full loot of his house. I don't like all these caps. Pre-war books. And Stimpaks. And other drugs. I don't think I need an ophthalmoscope. Especially since I don't even know what it does. Sweet. Definitely create some drugs. Excellent. Ooh, one of each. Fantastic. I've been meaning to have some drugs. That's the first Nuka-Cola I've seen. Hey, Doc.
Welcome back. I had hope. Seems like wherever I go, it's always the same. Folks just never leave each other alone.
Yeah, you know, war never changes.
Bum leg. And my supplies are scarce, but I'll give you what I can spare. I ain't got much, but it'll do you more good out there than it will in here. Take what I got. I didn't see him or the men with him. You might ask around town, though. Could be someone saw which way they was headed. Your best bet would probably be Trudy, the bartender at the saloon up the road. If anyone saw anything, she'd know about it.
Hey. Lots of pre-war books in here. I don't know if these are worth anything out here, but I can always take them back east if I can find out where the train is, at least. They're worth a lot back there. Alright, I guess that's about all of this place. I think. Yeah. Ooh, it's dark out. Look at those stars, mate. Alright, who else do I need to talk to? Oh yeah, the store guy. Chet. Nice bedroll.
Hey there. You must be the one Doc Mitchell was patching up.
That's me.
Hey, I heard it. I didn't think you'd be walking out of that office. I've got plenty of supplies for sale. Even got some weapon mods and special ammo. Well worth the caps if you ask me. If you're hurting,
well,
caps,
I will be interested in taking a look at that.
Boxes of surplus ammo in the miscellaneous section. They're not great, but you get what you pay for.
Okay.
Now just hold on. I never voted to take on the Powder Gangers. That's a 1,000-cap investment you're talking about.
I understand, but...
You made your point. I can provide people with some leather armor and extra ammo. Sure hope it's worth it. And, I'll be guarding the store while all this is going on. I have to put my business first. You understand.
I do understand. I'm a businessman myself.
If Ringo doesn't head out on his own, I think we should hand him over. The town shouldn't get itself mixed into the problem.
Too late for that.
Mistake that for coward talk, though. Mm. We're a town of survivors. We'll fight tooth and nail if pushed, but we don't go looking for trouble. Weapon mods are things like silencers, scopes, bigger magazines.
Yeah, I'm familiar.
Special ammo includes things like armor-piercing bullets, which don't hurt the target as much, but let you punch through armor easier. There's also hollow-point bullets, which have the opposite effect. You can kill unarmored targets easier, but they don't do shit against armor. The leader was a New Vegas type. Typical city boy. He had a bunch of Great Khans with him, probably hired guns. The Great Khans normally stay in their own territory way up
competition,
north,
eh?
On account of them all being right. Enemies with the NCR.
Isn't everybody?
Twice. Both times I drank a lot of liquor and lost most of my caps at the card tables. In that order, now that I think about it. If you ever get to New Vegas, be sure to visit Gamora. It's the best casino in the city. You won't regret it. Word of advice, behave. Between the NCR military police and Mr. House's robots, you don't want to be causing trouble on the Strip.
Good to know.
I'm afraid I don't know much myself. Mr. House has got his own casino, Lucky 38, but nobody goes in or out except his robots. The other casinos follow Mr. House's rules.
So do his robots gamble?
Makes him the leader of New Vegas. As far as I know, nobody's ever laid eyes on the guy. I think that robot who pulled you out of the dirt belongs to Mr. House. If Mr. House is looking after you, it's got to be a good thing, right?
Maybe.
They're tough sons of bitches. Mean, but not crazy. They'll leave you alone unless you got something they want. The Great Khans deal in illegal chems.
Ah.
There's a good chance that most chems you come across were made by Great Khans.
Seems like I need to get to know these fellas.
Take it easy now.
Alright, we'll come back later and shop with you. But for now, I think it's time to get this party started. I should maybe take her a little rest first. Well, no, actually, it might be best to do this at night. Use my sneaky skills. Yeah, me. Oh wait, you know what else we should do? I mean, I'm so used to having Moira and Sydney around. I mean, you're awesome in a fight and all, meat, but might not hurt to see if we can round up a few extra guns. Most likely place to start is probably going to be this guy in the power armor over here. I mean, he's got a power armor and a laser rifle. I don't know what his deal is. Well, he talks.
Hey there, Wanderer. Care to hear a... Wait, I know you. You're the courier, aren't you?
The courier?
I can't believe it's you.
I mean, people back home used to talk to me as, or refer to me as the Lone Wanderer.
I mean, we just met. I mean, but, well, I'm a huge fan. It would be my honor to help document your travels. You see, I'm a storyteller by trade. A story like yours is rare to come by.
I could tell you a lot of stories. I didn't know I was famous out here already, though.
Great. Got loads of stories for you, but I'll try to keep my mouth shut. I'll try.
Alright, friend. Well, let's see.
What's your story? Let's see here. No luck, I'm afraid. The words of the pages have long since faded away to be anywhere. If there were any stories in here, they're now long gone. On the plus side, our toilet paper shortage is now resolved.
Fair enough.
Let's see here. By the glow, yes. Between these damaged pages is a tale complete and intact. Yep, pre-war printing, too stubborn to be dislodged by the sands of time.
Excellent.
Thank you for this gift, friend. I'll stick by our deal and give you a tale of my own in exchange. I think I have just the story in mind. Would you like me to tell you the story now, or should we save it for another time?
Another time, we've got a fight to get to. Well. Let's see. Anybody else we can round up around here? Who are you? Good Springs Settler. I don't think you're the kind of person we can round up. Anybody home in here? Oh, who's this little waif? Hello?
Hey, what are you doing here? I'm Delilah, and this is my place. I don't normally take too kindly to strangers barging in on me, but I happen to have helped the doc save you.
Well, thanks, I guess.
Flatterer. I'm jealous of the life of a courier. Seeing the wastes, it must be great.
If only I could remember any of it.
Mainly, I help Doc Mitchell around the clinic. I'm going to be a doctor one day. I think I'll need more experience than what he can show me here. Ever since I lost Uncle Sulik, it hasn't really been the same. I think I need to strike out and find my own destiny. Uncle Sulik was like my dad's brother, but not really. See, Dad was raised near tribals in California and had a close relationship with them.
I've heard about tribals, but we didn't really have those back in
D.C. Make a life for themselves in the
D.C.
Uncle Sulik came with them to protect my parents. Something about
being the Brotherhood tended to call everybody tribals,
like,
but they weren't really.
Taught me a lot of tribal medicine. He showed me how to make his ancestral pain remedy. Voodoo. It's very potent and very addictive. Be careful with it.
So you can make drugs.
Shadow Walker potion and the process for extracting what he
called
crag hash from some plants.
I think I definitely need to talk you into coming with me.
Powder is an old remedy he had used in the days as a young brave with his tribe. It uses concentrated tobacco with a stimulant.
Even if I'm not sure if you're old enough for me to have sex with.
Since the Great War, his tribe had survived for generations in a mountain tunnel complex. They crawled out from the caves in those mountains after the bombs fell, and they remain sacred to his people to this day.
That sounds stupid.
Sulik said that giant geckos led them
religious
to the
bullshit.
Caves. And as the mountains are sacred to them, so are the geckos that live there.
Oh, wow, they worship geckos. Wow, they're really fucking stupid.
What do you want to know? My parents were from California. They came all the way to Good Springs in search of their own little piece of heaven. I was born here. Mitchell's autodoc said pancreatic cancer. I'd rather really not talk about that, if you don't mind. Rad scorpions. He was coming back from a trading run and he must have walked into a nest of the big fuckers. Sulik searched for him when he didn't come back on schedule, but he found him too late. The poison had run its course.
Such language from you, young lady.
What do you want to know? I'm going to be. I helped Doc Mitchell out, and Sulik taught me some tribal methods, but I will be a doctor one day. What do you want to know? Uncle Sulik taught me a lot about the ways of his people, and I admire them in a lot of ways. I don't consider myself a tribal, though. I guess the most useful thing he taught me about was tribal medicine.
Drugs.
He taught me to fight with sticks, but mainly, he was just Uncle Sulik.
Fight with sticks? Doesn't seem very useful.
It's something Uncle Sulik used to say. Instead of dying, when we all leave this life, we meet those we loved at the clearing at the end of the path.
Yeah, it sounds pretty stupid.
I like it. I think it adds some dignity to death.
No, death is just dying.
I I'd love to. I think this is exactly the opportunity I've been waiting for. Let me grab my things.
All right.
I forgot to mention, I'll be able to help you out with your medical chems. I know some tricks I can show you to make them last.
Oh, that sounds good.
I can also make a couple of tribal remedies if you need them.
Yes, please.
All right. Okay, here you go.
What do you get? You get a weapon? No, apparently.
Some of the older fiends would make great research cases. I think they've managed to preserve their organs with all the chemicals they've ingested.
Need to meet these fiends, I guess.
Doesn't take much more than some hillbillies and the smell of Brahmin dung to remind a girl why she left home.
Alright. Well, meat, we've acquired a little army now. I think this will be sufficient to take on these powder gangers. It feels a bit like the old days, only I've got a dude in power armor instead of a hot chick following me. Wake up, fool.
So what's going on? Did Sunny agree to help us? Well, I guess that means we're ready to go. Unless you...
Nope.
All right, I'm ready. I hope.
Time to look alive. The Powder Gangers are here to play.
Well, I'm ready to play too.
Oh, Easy Pete came through with the dynamite. Here's your supply. I really hope I don't blow myself up. I'll be set up near the store. Let's hope that
I hope so too. That would be a waste of a perfectly good ass. Alright. Might as well start with this dynamite. I see him a-coming. Alright. Damn it, I can't hit any of them from here. Now I can. Have a little of that! And some of that.
I owe you a huge favor.
Caps.
Here, these are technical. It's all I've got with me. But if you look me up at the Crimson Caravan's main camp in New Vegas, I'll pay you in full.
Sounds good. Yeah, let's loot these fools. Didn't I see one of them with a cool looking hat? What was that?
Welcome back, Sue.
Yeah, there it is.
Friend, you're listening to Galaxy News Radio.
Wait a minute, where's that coming from?
The heart and soul of the Capitol for over 10 years.
Is that coming from you? I don't think that satellite I put up there was good enough for getting the sound all the way out here. This seems like a fitting new look. I think I'm gonna roll with it. Alright, well, let's get some sleep. We don't wanna head out on the road in the middle of the night.
I'm glad that business is.
You seem to be wounded. Who's that robot fella?
Howdy, partner. Can't say that I'm familiar with the rascals. Some of the fine folks in town might be able to help you out with that.
What good are you?
I moseyed into town, 10, 15 years ago. Before that, I can't quite seem to recall. Odd. Anyway, it's a right peaceful town, and I reckon it's as fine a place to settle as any.
Yeah, I don't trust you either. I am, however, going to use your shack. Settle down there, Delilah.
You know, you remind me of a young Ernest Hemingway sometimes.
What does that mean?
Okay.
You are really skinny. All right, well, let's get on back out here. Let's go hit up the shop, sell off whatever crap we don't need. Actually, first, let's see what we have here. Repair up our 10mm pistol. Got a couple varmint rifles, a couple single shotguns. Nothing else repairable there. You don't want your guitar?
That was a hell of a fight. Let's hope it doesn't bite us in the ass later on.
If you say so.
Can do.
I don't really care, personally. Don't need a Silence 22 because I've already got a Silence 10. Laser pistol combat sights. And a recycler. Too bad I don't use laser pistols. Yeah, definitely get those away from me. All right. Oops. I did not mean to drop it on the ground. That's more like it. Now I feel like a real cowboy.
Morning.
Where's that Sunny Lassie? Yeah, screw it. Anywho, I guess we need to head to Prim now. Apparently, if we just follow the road out this way, we will get there eventually. I guess I can take this storyteller fellow with me. I was kind of just rounding him up originally to get in that fight, but he seems to want to tag along, and seems pretty handy with that laser rifle, so might as well, right? This is what they mean by big sky country, huh? Settle, mate. Settle. Wait, what did it say? Prim that way. Okay.
You're listening to Three Dogs. Wow, wow, on Galaxy News Radio, the number one radio station in the greater metropolitan area. Actually, the only radio station in most of Washington, D.C. these days. Except for people who live near that old lady with the violin. Wah, wah, wah.
Howdy.
Do you know why your robot is spouting radio from something a long ways away?
Sure.
Maybe later.
That's a good question.
Nope. Not interested in anymore. She won't tell me about your damn robot. What are you laughing at? A star bottle cap, eh? Looky here. Alright then. Ooh, NCR money. I wonder if that's worth anything. Take it. Drugs. I guess that's the roller coaster. So we're going the right way. That's the good news. Of NCR money. Nobody's hurt. Keep on moving. Seem to want to play. Got you. Actually seem to attack me.
You're listening to Galaxy News Radio, the heart and soul of the Capitol.
I'm actually not listening to the radio. That's what's weird about this. This is the place.
Hey, where the hell do you think you're going? Prim is off limits.
I go where I want, pig.
It's your ass. Don't say you weren't warned.
I won't. You're not the boss of me. You fuckers run the wasteland. You assholes set a minefield up, huh? Actually, take these, they're worth money. Next time I find a store, that is. You're a strange looking little dog. Yeah, I guess I can have my doctor lady fix you. Be in a weird spot. Oh, hi. Taking your stuff. All right, now, dog. Oh, great, our army's growing. Well, on the good news, meat, you might get laid soon.
Hey, you need something? Okay.
All right. Thing on your arm. Is that a fake Pip-Boy or something? No. Dead body in the streets. Oh wait, Mojave Express. That's who I'm supposed to work for. Speaking of which, didn't I have a note from them? Yeah, here we go. Deliver the package to the north entrance of the Vegas Strip by way of Freeside. Agent of the recipient will meet you at the checkpoint, take possession of the package, and pay for delivery. Bring the payment to Johnson Nash at the Mojave Express Agency in Prim. Hey, that's here. Bonus on completion, 250 caps, that's pretty lame. One oversized poker chip composed of platinum. Bunch of crap. Now, who's this dead body? Seems like he was a fellow courier. Seems like the exact same job. Only he had oversized fuzzy dice.
Ed, nah, don't get jealous. You're special in your own way. Albeit, you seem to have rolled off the same assembly line.
It's another robot just like his. Well, I mean, I've already got one robot following me. Why not two, I guess? Alright, whatever. Alright, so where's this Johnson Nash fella? I'll take a scotch, since he doesn't seem to be here. Also, his magazines.
Some of the older fiends would make great research cases. I think they've managed to preserve their organs with all the chemicals they've ingested.
I don't know what it was brought you to Prim, youngster, but you might want to rethink your plans. Town's gone to hell.
You don't say. Didn't look too great on my way in.
Johnson Nash is my name. Husband to Ruby Nash. Lived in Prim going on 8 years now, thick and thin.
Well, you're the asshole I'm looking for.
Primarily, for what it's worth with things like they are. I also run the local Mojave Express outpost.
Did you realize there was a dead body of a courier out there? Also, I work for the company,
well,
apparently.
I don't got any work right now, sorry to say.
I wasn't looking for any.
I'll tell you whatever I can. You have a delivery order you can show me? Oh, you're talking about one of them packages. That job had Strange written all over, but we couldn't turn down the caps.
Yeah, well, I understand that.
That cowboy robot had us hire 6 couriers.
Victor?
Each was carrying something a little different. A pair of dice, chess piece, that kind of stuff. Last word I have in the office, it looked like payment had been received for the other 5 jobs. Guess it was just your chip that didn't make it. First deadbeat we hired to do the job, canceled. Hope a storm from the divide skins him alive. Well, that's where you came in. Yeah, got this look when he saw you next down on the courier list. His expression turned right around. Asked me if your name was for real.
I am the one and only Solomon.
Like a rain, you were still kicking. Then he turned down the job.
Author of the Wasteland Survival Guide.
Sure, it was good money. No, let Courier 6 carry the package. That's what he said. Like the Mojave'd sort you out or something. Then he just up and walked out. No idea. Sounds like you two had a history for him to act like that. And turn down the money, too. Hope he didn't see any trouble in that package of yours. Maybe he thought your name was bad luck. Enough for me to say. Well, now that you mentioned it, a few nights back, one of the townies was out scavenging for supplies. He said he saw a fellow with a daisy suit come through with some of them great
kind of daisy suit.
They was talking about a chip. Well, for that, your best bet is going to be talking to Deputy Beagle. Since they came to town, he was keeping a good bit of notes on them.
See the backup for Sheriff Pitbull?
When your pretty boy friend came through, he may have heard where they were going. I guess I don't have anywhere better to be. A Beagle had some notes he was taking while he was eavesdropping around the Powder Gangsters. He'll be your best source of information on that subject.
Well, I bet he's good at eavesdropping too with those big floppy ears.
Sure, I'll tell you what I know. Right now, Beagle is the closest Prim's got to any organized law, but he's still stuck up in Bison Steve. First thing I'd say is get his sorry butt out of there. Well, sure do. I run the courier office out of my shop. Leastways I did before things went to hell around here. Let's see. Been tough around here for a good while now. Worse since them thugs kidnapped our deputy. It started with the breakout from the prison up the road. First there was just a few thugs rolling through town, but then they got organized. Now they call themselves Powder Gangsters or something. And run around throwing dynamite and shooting people.
Which, you know, does sound like fun.
Them left whatever kind of organization they got up there to squeeze all the food and drink out of us they could.
Yeah, not the stupidest move they can make.
That's where we are. This here little casino brought some cash and bodies into the town before them Powder Gangsters came in. Now, they can't rush us without eating a good bit of hot lead, but we are in a
better kind of fix this place up then.
Guess this is a fitting place for that as any. I reckon that if they thought hard enough about it, they'd realize they got more bodies than we have bullets. But for now, we're safe enough in here. It's an old hotel and casino here in town. Old Laura used to rent out rooms there, but she took off months ago. Across the way from the Vicky and Vance, the other old casino. Can't miss it.
That beat-up old pile of bolts? What do you want to know? The courier dropped it off a little bit ago. I'd hoped to get it up and running for some courier work, but never could get it running.
No, you're not very smart, are you?
Not a bit. I imagine there must be some people around curious about that kind of technology.
Well, you can call Beagle a deputy so long as you don't harbor too high an opinion of the word.
No, I definitely don't.
Boy was about as useful as tits on a rad scorpion.
That, sir, is a fantastic expression that I'm going to be using from now on.
Still, I suppose he don't deserve what's befell him. We would have considered paying the ransom if we'd had caps to spare.
People without caps are about as useful as tits on a rad scorpion.
Gangers, gangsters, all sounds like trouble to me.
Fair enough. Alright. Here, I'm gonna go... Here we go.
Got that old robot up and running again? How's it working out for you?
You know, I'm good with fixing stuff.
Sure, have a look.
I'm gonna hang on to these for now. But I can get better prices for them somewhere else. Yeah, let's get rid of these. Get rid of these 9mm pistols. A shotgun. Mines. Hang on to the dynamite for now. Alright, you get anything fun? Nothing there. I don't believe I have a 25mm GAPW, so that's not really helping me out much. Especially not at that price. Plasma pistol high energy ionizer. I don't use those either. What about some bullets? 357s are good. Yeah, that's about it. Alright. Okay, so apparently we have to go rescue the deputy from this building over here. But I think I'm in need of a rest after that walk. And Jesus Christ, look at the little army we've built for ourselves. May have no idea where we are or what's been going on for the last few years, but... still good at rounding jackals up to follow me. Come here, gang. Well, anyways, I think that's about enough for today. I think I'm going to go get some shut-eye and call this a wrap. Let's see, I heard the sheriff's dead, so... that was a weird noise. Hopefully we can use his bed or something. Let's see what we got in here. Oh. They didn't actually clean out the bodies. That's nice. Well, I've slept in weirder places. Come on. Yeah, there appears to be some bits of them left on the bed, but, you know, we'll make do. Sleep on this side. Alright, guys, well, this has been episode... I guess we're going to continue the episode numbers, so we're going to call this episode 15, but the series itself will be changing the name to The Misadventures of Solomon. The fuck was that? Jesus Christ, Meat, what did you do? Bad dog. Misadventures of Solomon in the Two Wastelands. So, as that goes, yeah, this has been episode 15 of Misadventures of Solomon, and we will see you guys next time.